I'm in York at the moment. I'm in my new room and my new house, and it's great. I'm starting my second year of uni, which I'm super excited about. And I've got this cute mug with hot water in it because it's really healthy. I know, like, I remember last year, people in my old flat, they were like, Emma, why are you drinking hot water for? So weird, but it's good for you. Yeah. It's actually, okay, I should put it down because I'm only moving my hands a lot. So yeah. Okay, this video is about lessons learned. So what I learned over the summer. And one cannot expect to trust someone they don't know. That was the lesson that I learned.
The story begins.
Basically, over the summer, I worked at a shoe shop, I worked in a fashion house, and I worked at a bank, and then I went on holiday. Well, holiday was before bank, but yeah. The thing I want to talk about is my job at Karma Rock, which is a fashion charity. It was awesome. I loved it there because I grew a lot as a Christian, because the boss is Christian and it's like a Christian organisation. And I remember I'd asked Faith, because I'm really into people like analysing other people, and it's like I find it super interesting. And so I remember asking Faith about like how she analyses people and stuff, and she said to me that she prays about everyone who comes into her life, for God to show her who they really are so that she can give them what they need. And I thought that was, I've never heard of that before. I thought it was like, whoa, that is really cool. Because it makes sense, because God knows everyone. You know, God knows the heart of every person. So it makes sense to ask him, because he's all knowing. But yeah, so I remember I asked her, oh, what about me? Like, what do you think of me? And she didn't say, until near the end of the time, my time there. We were just like in a discussion after work, and people were asking her about her experiencing, asking questions, and then she just turned to me and she said, Emma, you wanted to know about my perception of you, and she told me basically, she said, you base a lot of what you know on assumptions, and you base a lot of what you know like from what you hear and stuff, rather than actually knowing it. And she said, this will destroy you. And I was like, and I felt like crying big time, like emotions were welling up in me, and I knew I had to get out there as soon as possible, because she had said that in front of other interns, like other people. And so I like quickly had to escort myself. I was like, bye, I'm gonna go, see you later, with like a smile on my face. And I left, and I remember when I got out the door, just these emotions of pride started rising up in me, and like, who does she think she is, you know, to tell me that, you know, how dare she say that in front of other people, like why didn't she take me to the side, you know, just these thoughts, you know, ungodly thoughts were coming to me, and I knew that they weren't of God, so I knew I had to reject them. But it seems so natural to feel those emotions, like it would make sense if you're an up, do you know what I mean? But it's not of God, because when someone corrects you and when they tell you something that is true and they point out your fault, you should take it humbly. And this is what I had to do. I literally had to make a decision to be humble and be like, Lord, like not dislike her, because emotions of like dislike against Faith, like who does she think she is, you know, why is she? And so I literally had to make a conscious decision to pray for her and to be thankful, because like the emotions of like dislike and hatred and pride was like, they were there. I'm not saying they weren't there, the feelings were there, but feelings can lie to you. And I just had to reel in like my emotions, my thoughts in line with the word of God. And I did that through my mouth. So I prayed for her. I was like, thank you, Heavenly Father, for Faith. Like, she's blessed in the name of Jesus. And I had to do that. And literally, because you know, you are master of how you feel, you decide how you feel, you decide where you go in life, and your thoughts. I was able to do that. And by the end of it, like, I was like, emotions of happiness and joy and thanksgiving were there, and pride, like pride left. I rebuked it, like I refused to be prideful, and I refused to dislike anybody, because the love of God was shed abroad in my heart. So literally I was just speaking the word of God, and I remember I went home and I thought about it. I was thinking, man, this thing could destroy me, like I could potentially die as a result of this fault. I was like, whoa, that is serious. So I just began to thank God. I remember that night I opened my Bible, and she said that word. I knew that word came from the Lord, because the Holy Spirit had told me about this issue that I had beforehand, how I would base my knowledge and what I would know and what I would think on other people, like from sermons, like pastors, and from, you know, what I listen to, you know, podcasts, like from Joyce Meyer and Creflo Dollar, and I would know as a result of them, but it wasn't coming from me spending time with the Word of God. And it's not a bad thing, it's a wonderful thing to be like listening to the Word all the time, it's awesome, but it's vital for you to go back into the Bible and take what the pastors have said and read it for yourself, so that you know that you know that you know the revelation for yourself. Because literally, during the end of my year last year at university, I was going through some challenges and I wasn't succeeding. Like, I didn't have faith to, you know, overcome in those challenges and to victor. And I remember thinking when I was walking home from lecture, this thought came through my head. I'm thinking, you know, why am I not succeeding? Why can't I use my faith? Why isn't my faith working? Not that your faith doesn't work, it's because you don't have faith. But I remember thinking, you know, why am I not overcoming these challenges? And it was later that I realised, like, after she had told me, and I went home to read the Word, I'm like, man, I haven't read the Word in so long. And basically what I'd been doing was I was running on fuel that I had filled myself with back, like, not years back, but like, back then. And it was time for me to like fill myself with more fuel so I could keep going. And the reason why I couldn't keep going in a successful way was because I didn't fill myself with fuel. Because obviously, like with my previous video, life at university, I was telling you about my challenges with that and not really spending that much time in the Word of God, being distracted. And so, yeah, and I suffered as a result of that. So thank God that this correction came to me, because the Holy Spirit had told me before, but I didn't listen. And God will like find any way to get your attention, and He did. Thank God for that, literally. And so, yeah, and so I literally read the, I started reading the Word, and I reading the Word again, and then I was, and yeah, and when a correction comes, and when someone points out a fault, you should, and this is what I did, I planned, like a correct road of correction, you know, to get back on the right track, and I decided to make, to spend the first, an hour in the morning praying and meditating on the Word of God and spending that quality time with God. Because I remember my pastor said, if you love somebody, you would want to spend quality time with them. So for example, if you have a boyfriend or girlfriend or a really, really good friend that you love to talk to, you would spend hours on the phone with them. You would meet up at a cafe and just chat and spend time, you know. And that's the same with people, and the reason why is because you love them and you enjoy their company. And that's the same with God. Like, you need to spend quality time, because faith is trust, and how can you trust someone you don't know? The reason why I couldn't use my faith at the end of last year was because I didn't know God, I didn't know His Word, I didn't know what He said concerning that situation. I might have known it from hearing it in church and from like pastors and whatever, but I didn't know it for myself. I didn't write it in my heart, I just had it in my brain, if you get my drift. And so yeah, that was the lesson that I learned, and literally it's been amazing. So when I went on a holiday in Germany and Austria, I remember I prayed beforehand that this holiday wouldn't just be meaningless in the sense that I'm just sightseeing and eating food. It's meaningless in the sense that it doesn't carry any spiritual weight. I'm not making any impact with the gospel. I'm not making any impact with the Word of God in the kingdom of God. Like, there's no lasting legacy. So I pray that it would have spiritual weight and significance. And God is awesome, because He always answers your prayers. And I thank the Lord for that, because He's faithful. And as a result of that holiday, I actually went with a secondary school friend and a uni friend, and the girl that I went with, Lynn, she gave her life to Christ as a result of us spending time together just talking about God. And she had lots of questions, and you know, I was feeding her the answers, and yeah, and the Holy Spirit convinced her. And I remember, like, I would be praying for her as well and meditating on the Word of God and praying for her and stuff, and she finally gave her life to Christ. So praise the Lord, He's awesome. And And yeah, and that's it, man. Don't expect to be able to use your faith if you don't even know the Word of God. Like, don't expect to succeed in life if you don't know the Word of God, if you don't know who you're putting your trust in. Because it's literally, you can't put your trust in someone you don't know. That's it. Have an awesome, awesome week, and I'll see you soon. Bye.